Let there be glory and honor and praises.
Glory and honor to Mary. Glory, honor, glory and honor to her.
She's the star of the ocean. She's the lighthouse along the way.
She's a comfort to those in darkness.
She's a beacon for the ones astray. Let there be glory and honor and praises.
Glory and honor to Mary. Glory, honor, glory and honor to her.
Good morning, dear brothers and sisters.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit is with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Let us pray. O God, who in the font of baptism have made new those who believe in you, keep safe those reborn in Christ, that defeating every onslaught of error, they may faithfully preserve the grace of your blessing through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
For the first reading, please take page number 128 of the New Testament. The first reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, verses 31 to 42, on page number 128 of the New Testament. The church throughout all Judea and Galilee and Samaria had peace and was built up and walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit, it was multiplied. Now, as Peter went here and there among them all, he came down also to the saints that lived at Lydda. There he found a man named Aeneas, who had been bedridden for 8 years and was paralyzed. And Peter said to him, Aeneas, Jesus Christ heals you. Rise and make your bed. And immediately he rose, and all the residents of Lydda and Sharon saw him, and they turned to the Lord. Now, there was at Joppa a disciple named Tabitha, which means Dorcas or Gazel. She was full of good works and acts of charity. In those days, she fell sick and died. And when they had washed her, they laid her in an upper room, since Lydda was near Joppa. The disciples, hearing that Peter was there, sent two men to him, entreating him, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter rose and went with them. And when he had come, they took him to the upper room. All the widows stood beside him, weeping and showing coats and garments which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all outside and knelt down and prayed. Then, turning to the body, he said, "Tabitha, rise." And she opened her eyes. And when she saw Peter, she sat up. And he gave her his hand and lifted her up. Then, calling the saints and the widows, he presented her alive. And it became known throughout all Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsory psalm is taken from Psalm 116, verses 12 to 17, and our response to the psalm. How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me?
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me?
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? The cup of salvation I will raise. I will call on the Lord's name. Our response.
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me?
My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people. Oh, precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. Our response. How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds. A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the Lord's name. Our response.
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me?
Acclamation.
God has spoken to his people. Alleluia. And his words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
Open your ears, Christian people. Open your ears and hear good news. Open your hearts, O royal priesthood, God has come to you. God has spoken to his people, alleluia. And his words are words of wisdom, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 6, verses 60 to 69. When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you, there are some who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe, and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." Jesus answered them, "Did I not choose you, the 12? Yet one of you is the devil." He was speaking of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, for he, though one of the 12, was going to betray Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, from today's Gospel, we reflect three things. The first one, we should remain to serve the Lord. The second one, Jesus is the best refuge. And thirdly, Jesus has the words of eternal life. The first one, we should remain to serve the Lord. Disciples of Lord Jesus Christ were leaving Jesus and going. What could be the reason? Jesus was preaching, "I am the bread of life. People, whoever eats my flesh, drinks my blood, such as the people have the life of eternal." According to the Jewish understanding, they have been misinterpreting, how can a human being eat human flesh? How can a human being can drink a human blood? It's a cannibals. This is something strange. But they were not understanding what Jesus meant. Jesus was speaking about his own body and flesh, means after. Whoever participates in him, whoever acknowledges him, whoever receives him, such as the people have the life and life in abundance. In the Old Testament, Joshua, before he was leaving this world, he called 12 tribes and people. And he was telling. He gathered at Shechem. And he was telling, "Our God is a God, Yahweh is a true God. The choice I have given to you. I have been giving importance to my God. Whoever gives importance to God, Yahweh, God keeps promises. And in his presence, you can come up in your life. But choice has given again. If you want to worship the God of Amorites, you will reach nowhere. But I'm still giving my importance to my God, the Creator, is God Yahweh." Peter too expressed the same. When people failed to understand Jesus' words, they were leaving. "Peter, do you leave me?" Peter doesn't want to leave Jesus. He's the one who experienced Jesus totally. He's the one who was closest possible disciple and is loving Jesus the most. "Lord, where shall we go?" Means he understood Jesus is a Messiah. Now what I'm trying to tell you, my dear brethren, sometimes the word of God challenges us. Sometimes very difficult to understand or very difficult to follow the word of God. As a result, our mind gets diverted. There are chances of leaving. Jesus is asking to each one of us, "My dear brother, my dear sister, are you too leaving me?" What would be our answer? The second question. The second one, Jesus is the best refuge. Peter said, "Lord, where shall we go?" Yes, my dear brethren, if Jesus asks, "Are you too leaving?" Our answer should be, "Lord, where shall we go?" Because he is the true God, and he is the one who is a living God, who shed his blood on the cross, and is the one who is loving us. Are we getting better than Jesus? Keep reflecting. And third one, Jesus has the words of eternal life. "I am the living bread. My words are eternal. It is not who I am speaking. It is my Father who sent me, wanted to communicate the same. I have come to do His will. Whoever follows me has the life in abundance with the help of my Father. And we have been experiencing Lord Jesus Christ through Eucharist and experience Him, encounter Jesus and receive the eternal life. Amen.
For the offertory, please take hymn number 216, 216.
Lord, God of all creation, for the goodness we have
and to spread your Lord, I give everything
to God forever.
I give what my feet to go your way, and every step I shall take cheerfully.
Lord, God of all creation, for the goodness
of God. The joy of the Lord is my strength, my strength. For the joy of the Lord is my help, for the power of the Spirit is in my heart, and the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifices at your hands
for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to Lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through Him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For His death is our ransom from death, and in His rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they proclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord of our and might, earth and heaven sing Hosanna in your praise. Blessed who comes in the name of the Lord, sing Hosanna in the highest, praise the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time He was betrayed and entered willingly into His passion, He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to His disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, He gave it to His disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bala, Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Rosie, Sister Margarita, Joe and Barbara Nayak, Romy Fernandez, Antumani Paul, Joseph Thomas, Amala Thomas, Jovita Crasto, and Mary Crasto, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, all the saints who are pleased with throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not in our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, may take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the Lord bless you.
Hymn number 796.
into thine own womb. At the dawn of Easter morning, when the stone was rolled away, then from the darkness rose in glory Jesus Christ, true risen light, brightening all the earth's dark night. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ has risen from the dead. He has risen to thine own home. From the depths of fury bonded, all mankind has risen too. All eyes are open from their blindness to the light of heavenly view. And with Christ they rise anew. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ has risen from the dead. He has risen to die no more. At the dawn of Easter morning, when the stone was rolled away, then from the darkness rose in glory Jesus Christ, true risen light, brightening all the earth's dark night. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ has risen from the dead. He has risen to die no more.
The anima Christi,
soul of Christ,
sanctify me.
Body of Christ, save me.
Blood of Christ, inebriate me.
Water from the side of Christ, wash me.
Passion of Christ, strengthen me.
O good Jesus, hear me.
Within your wounds, hide me.
Suffer me not to be separated from you.
From the malignant enemy, defend me.
At the hour of my death, call me,
and bid me come to you,
that with your saints I may praise you for all eternity. Amen.
For the intentions of our Holy Father, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without an end. Amen.
Father, I pray for them, that they may be one in us, so that the world may believe it was you who sent me, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is celebrated. Go and glorify the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
For the final hymn, please take hymn number 800-800.
We shall rise, we shall rise. On the resurrection morning we shall rise. We shall rise, we shall rise. On the resurrection morning we shall rise. We shall then be with the Lord. We shall then be with him forevermore. We shall then be with the Lord.
Be with the Lord forevermore.
We shall rise, we shall rise. On on the resurrection morning we shall rise. We shall rise. We shall rise. On the resurrection morning we shall rise.